Good morning. Let's do some more discussion about muscles. We're going to talk about different types of muscle groups and different types of muscle contraction. As far as different types of muscle groups, they are coordinated with respect to how they function with each other or opposing each other. So for example, an agonist is the primary mover of the muscle. It creates the majority of the tension in whatever action we're speaking of. Tension is force created by a contracting muscle. So if we're talking about flexion of the elbow, the main mover or agonist for flexion of the elbow is actually, if we look at this diagram down here, I'm going to draw it in here. It's the brachialis muscle. It's not the biceps brachii. So that would represent the agonist or the primary mover with regards to flexion of the elbow. The synergist is the secondary mover. And the synergist assists the agonist. The synergist assists the agonist. So once again, in this example of flexion of the elbow, the biceps brachii would be the synergist. The agonist, if you will, is the main character doing the majority of the work. The synergist is a supporting character. It is assisting the agonist. The antagonist opposes the primary mover. Opposes primary mover or opposes the agonist. So the antagonist in a movie is in total opposition to the main character. In this example down here, the antagonist would be the triceps brachii muscle. And once again, we're talking specifically with flexion of the elbow. Okay. The fixator muscle is a muscle that impedes or prevents displacement of a muscle or a joint. So we'll say impedes displacement of bone or a joint. I think I said displacement of a muscle or a joint. I meant bone. It impedes the displacement of a bone or a joint. So when we think about flexion of the elbow, for example, and we look at the biceps brachii attaches superiorly to the scapula, specifically to the coracoid process of the scapula and the supraglenoid tubercle of the scapula. And so when the elbow is flexing, that muscle and the tendons of that muscle are pulling on the scapula. So we need muscles to prevent any movement or displacement of the scapula. And we've talked about in lab, for example, there are the rhomboids, which help stabilize or fix the scapula. There's the supraspinatus that helps fix the scapula. The infraspinatus, the subscapularis. That's agonist, synergist, antagonist, and fixator are different types of coordinated muscle groups. Okay, let's move on to different types of muscle contraction. And I'll be the first to tell you, I do fall into the mistake of frequently saying that muscle contraction is shortening of a muscle. And that's not necessarily the case. We have isometric contraction, where there is no change in length of the muscle. Isometric contraction suggests there is no change in the length of the muscle when the muscle is contracting. Iso means the same, metric refers to length. So if we look at the diagram to the right, you could be holding on to something with your elbow at that orientation, which is 90 degrees, and the muscle is not changing in length. I think a better example is if you're pushing against a wall or some force that is greater than your muscles are capable of creating. If you're pushing against a wall, you can be contracting your biceps brachii all day long, but they're not going to change length because you are not going to move or displace that wall. Isometric contraction is contraction of a muscle, but there is no change in length of that muscle. We also have isotonic contraction, where there certainly is a change in length of that muscle. And we have two different types of isotonic contraction. We have concentric contraction, and we have eccentric contraction. Concentric contraction, and in this case, we're decreasing the angle of this joint. So let's suggest we're now at roughly 45 degrees. Concentric contraction is when the muscle shortens. Concentric contraction is when the muscle shortens. Eccentric contraction is when the muscle lengthens. Eccentric contraction is when the muscle lengthens. So in this case, the arm is moving down here. So let's suggest we're at roughly now 120 degrees. So think of eccentric contraction when the muscle lengthens. You are holding a barbell, or let's say a dumbbell, and you're lowering your arm all the way down. So your arm is completely vertical, straight, down by your side. As you're lowering that dumbbell, your muscle, your bicep and brachialis are contracting. They're controlling your arm movement, so your arm just doesn't immediately flop down. So that is eccentric contraction. The muscle is lengthening. Whereas when you're contracting your muscle and pulling that dumbbell superiorly towards your head, decreasing the angle of a joint, that is concentric contraction. Concentric contraction. So isotonic contraction is when there is a change in length of the muscle. Okay, I hope this video helps you out with both different types of contraction and with the coordinated muscle groups.